Hello students, today we are going to learn the new lesson, The Little Bully. This is the lesson in which we are going to see a boy's story, which his name was actually Hari. Right students, before reading this lesson or before learning this lesson, students, can you tell me, do you have friends? Yes, obviously we all have friends, but in some case some friends were so much naughty. They always teases each other, they always try to fight, and they always pushes everybody in a class, right? We will call them as a naughty students or naughty friends. Many of time we avoid such a friends, right? But because of some unwanted reasons, we have to be with them. So students, let's see what happened with Hari, the naughty boy. Okay students, so I'm going to start the lesson. The naughty or that children, the little bully, okay? Okay, once upon a time, not so very long ago, there was a small boy called Hari. Look at that. There was a small boy and his name was Hari. Although he wasn't very big, he was strong and he loved to tease all the boys and girls. Look at that. His height was not very tall, but he was very strong. And he loved to tease all the boys and girls who went to school with him. Right? And then see what happened. What he loved to do most was to pinch with some instrument or with some fingers. He pinch always. Look at that, how he pinched the girl, okay, that girl's hand, and he could make a big bruise appear in a half second, and he make a bruise to appear in a half second. Another trick he played was pricking people with a pin. He tried to prick the pin on the hand, on the other part of body. So he loved these things to do with other children. So you can guess how all children hated him. So I think you may know that these kind of children were hated by other children, right? Yes. So his friend also hated him a lot. They tried pinching him back, but that was no good because he could always pinch harder. Other people always tried to pinching him back with some pins and other things, but he was stronger and therefore he pinched very harder than other people or other students. They didn't like telling their teacher because that was telling tales. They didn't like it to tell the teacher because it was like a telling tales, and therefore it so happened that the class went for the picnic. And one day what happened? One day the class went for the picnic to the seaside for a whole day. All the children were most excited. And the class of Hari one day went to picnic, where all the children were so excited of picnic, as we are also so much excited when we went to the picnic and for the trips, right students? Yes. Look at that. On that day, the sun shone bright. The atmosphere was very clear, and all the children were wild with excitement. Means all the children were so happy with excitement. They played so much. They played so much of games there. So they crowded into the train and sat down. Look at that train, how they enjoy there. But nobody wanted to sit next to Hari because he always pinched. And if you look that picture, in both the side pictures, there are two or more children are there. But in the middle of the train, the Hari was singly. He was singly sat down. Sorry. Because Hari always pinch other children, and therefore nobody want to sit in with him. Okay. So look at that next lines. When they arrived at the seaside, out jump all children with a shout of joy. And when their teacher took them to the seaside, they all come out and jump out, and all the children were happy. They shout in a joy, and the atmosphere is like very very pleasant. Down to sands they race, hand in hand, but nobody took Hari's hand. So they started playing games like running a race and playing with holding the hand in hand like this. But nobody was interested to took the Hari's hand. Nobody want to go near him. Hari was angry. And as the behavior of other students with him, Hari was very angry. He went to a sandy corner near a rocky pool and sat down by himself. Then what did he does? He went to a sandy corner and near the rocky pool and sat down lonely himself. He took out his lunch and looked at it. Then he opened his lunch box and looked at it. It was a good lunch. There were two hard-boiled eggs, six jam sandwiches, three pieces of bread and butter, a ginger cake, and a bar of chocolate he had in his tiffin. He would eat it all by himself. He wouldn't share anybody with, but he would eat it all by himself. He wouldn't offer anything to anyone. Then, just as he was beginning on the eggs, he heard a hoarse voice near him. He heard the terrible voice near him. "Good morning. I am so pleased to meet you, a boy like you." "Yes," and somebody called out that, "Hello, good morning. I am so pleased to meet you." So Hari turned around and stared in a fright. Yeah, Hari a little bit frightened because he was the only person is there, and therefore he was frightened and turned around and stared. Whatever do you think he saw? Do you think what did he saw there? Then Hari saw a monster crab. He saw the monster crab there. Look at the picture, and it was sideways out of the pool, and that crab was very near to the Hari, sideways to the pool. His eyes were on the ends of short stacks, and he looked most queer. His eyes were short stack like, and it looks most queer. Unusual crab is there. Okay, queer means unusual. He held out his front claw to Hari, and suddenly, you know that how hard claws are there of that crab. Okay, so he suddenly held out his front claws to the Hari. Hari put out his hand to shake the crab's claw, and Hari also put out his hand to shake the crab's claw. But to his surprise and anger, the crab opened his pincers and nipped his hand so hard that little boy yelled. And lo, what happened? That crab was in anger and surprise. He just opened his pincers. Look at that pincers. And then he nipped his hand so hardly to the little boy's Hari's hands. And therefore, Hari starts yelling. Okay. He starts crying. Then, "Hey, here is my good cousin," said the crab pleasantly. Also, here crab introduced another sea creature, we will say. To Hari's horror, he saw a large sandy lobster. Look at that picture. Here is a lobster which have long hairs, and that pinchers are there. Very hard pinchers are there. So large lobster is there, crawling heavily out of the pool with the crab. Before the little boy could stop him, the lobster took his hand in his great pincer like claws and pinched it so hard that Hari yelled. That lobster also did the same thing. It also took the Hari's hand in a great pincer of it, and like claws he also pinched it so hard, and therefore Hari was actually yelled in a pain, right? So look at that next line. Then he stared at the pool in surprise, for out come sandy colored shrimps. Shrimp means it was like a creature in the sea, and prawns, more crabs, and another large lobster, and they pricked Hari till he was soon black and blue with their pincers. So everybody comes, that many of creature comes out from the pool and they pinch Hari little bit till the Hari comes soon black and blue with their pinching. Then look at that, don't you like it? Said all creatures in surprise. And after pinching Hari, they ask question Hari to, don't you like it Hari, that pinching? Why? We were told you we were told you would love to see us because you were a champion pincer or a pricker yourself. Come join in the fun. And they ask Hari, we heard that you would love to see us because you are a champion pincher and we heard about you. Yes, and come and enjoy with us, join with us, like this. And then Hari realized that what guilty and what wrong things he had done before other children. Hari leaped to his feet crying loudly. His lunch rolled into the pool. And then after what happened, Hari suddenly leaped his feet and he cried loudly. His lunch rolled into the pool, fallen down. And when the crabs and lobsters saw it, they ran to it and began to feast eagerly. When the crabs and lobsters saw the food of Hari, they began to try to feast eagerly. Hari saw that they had forgotten him for a time. And he turned and ran for his life, tears streaming down his chicks. And what happened when the all that creatures of the sea, lobsters and crab, they were busy in eating that food of Hari, Hari suddenly run and turn for his life and tears come down on his cheeks. They only did to me what I keep doing to the other children, he thought. And then Hari realized that crab and lobster done only the thing that I behave with other children, he realized, but how it hurt and how I hated those crabs and lobsters. I suppose the other children hate me too. Well, I jolly well shan't pinch or prick my anymore. And now Hari decide that he will never ever pinch or prick any student, any friend anymore. And like that, Hari got a lesson to behave good with others, otherwise all people will hate you. So student, it is a nice story. I think you enjoyed it very well. We will see a question and answer in our next session, right? Till then, thank you for hearing.